Hey guys, welcome back to another Weird Wednesday. I'm Asherz, and this is...
Ivy.
So, something kind of crazy happened this week. The Pentagon declassified this, these, like, UFO videos that they had from, like, some of their, from the Navy, that the Navy released. And so the Pentagon had declassified these videos and basically said, like, yes, these belong to the government. It's just, like, these videos of, like, these really... you know, shitty cameras, and like these, you know, they can see what they think are UFOs on the video. And, you know, the Navy or the Pentagon just kind of admitted, yes, this belongs to the government. We took this, you know, the, it remains unsolved. We don't know what this is. The internet's freaking out about it. Everybody's freaking out about it. I don't think it necessarily means that they're admitting to alien life. I mean, you got to remember UFO stands for unidentified flying object. So because they don't know what it is, you know, technically, it's a UFO. But I thought that was interesting. I thought that was kind of cool. But it's like, you know, they declassified it, they said, because they wanted to clear up any rumors, which I thought was weird. Like,
right. What rumors need to be cleared up?
I guess because people were saying that, like, you know, some people were saying it wasn't real. Well, why would the government care if you thought that their video wasn't real about UFOs, you know? And then some people say, or, you know, they said it was because people thought that there was more to the videos that the government was keeping from us, and there's not. But it's just weird, you know.
But is there?
Is there more to it? Yeah. Right. Why would we believe them? They're like, this is it. We're releasing the whole thing. You know, that that doesn't make any sense, you know. So, I don't know, but, you know, that happened. So, you know, I just wanted to kind of briefly bring that up.
But anyway, what about Animal Crossing?
What about that Animal Crossing? Guys, we've got it bad. We've really got it bad for Animal Crossing. Ivy has... How many hours do you have in the game now?
I don't know. Last I checked, it was like 205 hours.
That's pretty bad.
Let me actually look and see what they are right now. Look up yours. What are your hours?
Sure. Let's look at mine. Let's see where I'm at with Animal Crossing.
I'm at 265 hours or more, and I've owned the game for about 2.5 weeks. Almost three.
I got Friend Request too.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah, I do. I got Friend Request. Where do I go? My profile. I'm at 120 hours or more. So
that's it.
That's it. You know, so I don't have that much, but that's still... that's a lot. You know, I play a lot of JRPGs personally, and you know, those games, they're like a minimum of 30 hours, and that's, you know, that's a decently long game. You know, then we're talking, some of them are, you know, 60 hours. It's a pretty long game. And then you got some that are like 200 hours, and like that's a big ass game.
But it doesn't seem like that when you play Animal Crossing.
It doesn't. No, it just, because you're always on it. You're always on it.
Yeah, it's crazy.
You know, and
they just suck you in.
It just goes day by day.
Tom Nook.
Do you think he's a slumlord?
Oh, most certainly.
You think so? That's true. You gotta pay for all your repairs and stuff. He's more like the bank, though. He's not really like a slumlord, because he wouldn't be your landlord. He's more like the bank.
Yeah.
You know,
what he told me?
What did he tell you?
He said, you want it, you fund it.
No, he did not say that.
Because I went to him to move my museum. And I had the money in my ATM, but I didn't have it on my person.
Okay.
I didn't think I'd have to go pull it out, because he knows how much I got in my ATM.
Right.
If he's the bank.
Right. Beach. Yeah. That's true. It's so what? You talk to him, you're like, hey.
Yeah. And I wanted to move the museum. So.
He chose the museum.
And that's when he told me, you want it, you fund it. Wow. Because I didn't have the bells on my person.
Guys, Tom Nook is savage as fuck.
He is.
I can't believe he said that to you. That's so rude.
Right.
Well, I had something kind of weird happen. I had a weird conversation with one of my villagers today, actually. You know, but let's explain the topic first. So today we're going to talk about like creepy Animal Crossing stuff. Animal Crossing has a lot of really fucked up shit in it, so we figured it would be fun to talk about, especially, you know, while everybody's at home, you guys are all playing the game, You know, let's go ahead and make it a part of your nightmares. So, we'll start off soft. We'll start soft. So this one, this conversation that I had with one of my villagers today was with Ozzy. And, you know, Ivy's been to my town. Probably some of you have too. Ozzy is a koala. And I talked to him and he starts talking to me about how, you know, he's like, hey, have you ever thought about maybe, you know, if our life was a game? And started like going on and on about how, like, isn't it weird that there's music playing all the time? And isn't it weird that the fruits grow so fast on the trees and like all kinds of stuff? Now, I had heard of other villagers kind of breaking the fourth wall and like suggesting that like life was a simulation, you know, and their life is a simulation, like they're aware that it's a game. But I've never actually like seen that conversation before, and like it happened today. I'm so excited that it did because we're recording this.
Right.
And but I took pictures of it. I'll post the pictures. I did take pictures. I'll post those to my social medias, you guys can see it. But I thought that was weird. It's fun. At the end of it, he's like, "Oh, I'm just kidding." Like he drops this deep shit on me. He talked for a long time. Like he talked about it for a while, and then he's just like, "Oh, just kidding." That's
well,
not real.
Well, today Pongo in my island was sick.
Okay.
And she was like, "I'd feel a lot better if I had some medicine." So I went and made her some medicine.
Okay.
And I took it back to her, and she said something about like how it was weird. And it was, like, from a game. What? I can't remember exactly what she said, but it was weird.
Because
like,
it's really easy to, like, miss the shit that they say.
Right.
Because
I'm
you just skip through it.
A.
Right. Right. You just skip, you know, right through the conversation.
Spam that A button.
Right. So it's really easy to, like, miss out on those little tidbits. And so I'm trying to, like, slow down a little bit and read it. It's hard. I'll be honest with you. It's hard. I have no patience. You know, I'm just trying to, you know, get something out of them or have them give me some type of mission or something. But yeah, it was cool. It was different. And then I know another big one that everybody's talking about is about the Easter bunny, basically the bunny Zipper.
Fucking creepy.
Yeah. Yeah. So with Zipper, apparently like, this isn't really creepy to me. But Zipper is somebody in a costume. And we know that because of like different, you know, aspects. Like his name's Zipper, first of all. He doesn't like you looking at his back. So like if you're behind him and you try to talk to him, like he'll freak out when he turns around. And then when he turns around and you can see his character, there's a zipper on the back of him. So he's not an actual bunny. He's somebody in a costume. So people, you know, are kind of speculating, like, who he is, you know.
It's Tom Nook.
Some people the thing is that Tom Nook's on the island the same time that Zipper is. Some people have thought it could be Tortimer. You remember the mayor from the games? I don't know if you've played the games that long. There's an old tortoise. You've probably seen pictures and stuff of him. He's, like, an old tortoise, and he used to be the mayor of, like, your towns and stuff and all the Animal Crossing games. But he's not around anymore. There's like some speculation that Tortimer is dead. So, yeah. So there's that one. But yeah, some people think it could be him. Some people think it could be Isabel. It could be Tom Nook. It could be one of the other characters that we've seen. Another theory is that it could be a ghost. Just
Wisp.
Well, like Wisp, right? It could be like Wisp. You know, it could be Red. You know, it could be all these different. You know, nobody really knows, but everybody knows that it is a costume.
It's Mabel.
It could
or
be
no,
Mabel.
Label.
Label, yeah, it couldn't be Label. Because
she doesn't do anything
That's
other than
true.
Stand in your town square.
But she is a new character, and Zipper's been around for a long time, so he's been somebody. Oh, I think she's new. I think she's newer.
Well, maybe that's how she gets
in. I'm
unveiled.
Pretty sure Zipper is, maybe. Zipper's older than her. He's an old character. I don't know, like, I don't necessarily find that one creepy, but some of your residents, like, some of your villagers, when you talk to them, they will, like, mention how they think he's creepy, and they're scared of him, and...
I just didn't like him.
What do you mean?
I didn't like him. Being there all
like
the time.
Anything about him. He really wasn't there all the time.
He was on my island for, like, 4 days.
What? He shouldn't have been.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck it was.
Your
well, mine
was weird.
Yeah, mine was messing
up
like crazy.
Yeah.
I don't know what the whole deal with that was.
That was weird. Yeah, yours was all messed up. No, he came on like the first day that like that season had started, and told you to find eggs, and then he wasn't there that day until the last... He didn't come back on my island until the last day. Maybe my game's fucked up. Like, he wasn't there the whole time.
Was he walking around and stuff? Yeah.
Because both times I seen him, he was in the plaza. He wasn't, like, walking around.
Weird.
But I never saw him walking around.
He was walking around on my island.
That is really weird.
But I also joined, like, in the middle.
Yeah, in the middle of that event. Right, exactly. So, I don't know. Maybe that's why. But I don't know. I mean, that's, like I said, I mean, that's weird that we both had different experiences with them. So maybe that's why people are creeped out by it. I don't know. Guys, I'm not afraid of a person in a bunny costume. I never have been. There are some people that are, you know, good for them. I don't know. You know, but that's a weird one. And then, of course, the secret alien message, you know, that's been... that's cool. That's a cool thing. I'm excited. I haven't tried it yet, but I'm excited. But supposedly, if you you have to get a TV in Animal Crossing, and if you do, apparently it's on Saturday night. Apparently, if you turn your TV on at 3:33 in the morning, you will get an alien signal, and it's creepy as fuck. It's scary. Like, it's really scary. Now, they did this in, like, the older games, and it's always been fucking scary.
Well, it was really scary in that game because the graphics were, like, shitty.
Or, like, the old games.
Yeah,
it's not as scary anymore, I don't think. I don't think the new, like, I've seen videos and stuff. I don't think it's as scary as it used to be, but it used to be fucking terrifying. And, you know, again, you guys, if you listened last week, you know, I'm fucking terrified of aliens. So, like, for me, this was horrible. I don't like this. You know, I don't know. That is weird. And that's something that you can do on the game regularly. But there's other things. There's a lot of other things. like, some people think that the towns that you go to across the Animal Crossing franchises are, like, child-killing cults. Like, that's what they think. And they think, you know, that there's some type of reason that you're... you know, a human. Like, why are you the only human wherever you are? That doesn't make any sense. And then it's like, you know, you've got like I've got a fucking chicken on my island right now. I hate her. But
also it's like, why is like Blathers the owl?
Mm-hmm.
Like, why does he have tasks and obligations? But the owl on the community board is just there.
It's just an owl. Like, that's it. Yeah. Yeah. Well, right. And it's like, why are, like, you can catch, like I said, I have a chicken. Okay. Relatively small, you know, creature or whatever. But then, like, in the game, you can catch, like, sharks. And they're, like, that's much bigger than a chicken. But it's not, like, considered sentient, I guess.
Right.
It's, you know, it's just, I mean, I guess it's sentient, you know, but not like they are. So why are they different? And then why are you a human? Animal Crossing would be so much cooler if you could pick any animal that you want to be that they have available out of all the animals, and then you can, like, customize your colors. Wouldn't it be better than that? I think it would be better if you could be an animal.
I think it'd be cute.
Yeah, instead of a villager. I mean, I like the villager. Don't get me wrong. I like the villager character. But I think I would like it better if he could be an animal instead. And it would just make more sense. I mean, there's no other humans anywhere. And then, like, you randomly get this letter from your mom, like, but, like, you know, she never comes to visit you, and, like, you never see her. Or, like, does she exist? Or what does she look like? Is she another animal? Maybe she's one of the campers that comes through, and it's just your mom, and you just, I don't know. I guess they all introduce themselves, so that doesn't make any sense. But, yeah, so, you know, that is, you know, all those different ties. It's weird that, you know, that everything is so different in the game, and I'm not sure what makes them different. Maybe they're part of, like, a chemical spill, or maybe that's why Tom Nook buys those areas. Because, like this game on the island, it was a deserted island, and he talks about, like, how, like, oh, it used to be deserted, now it's this great place, and blah, 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 blah. I mean, maybe it's because it's, you know, tainted land that he bought, and it was so cheap, and that's why he decided to kind of...
Right. Make some proper investments.
Make something out of it.
Because apparently he used to be a failing businessman.
What do you mean?
I don't know. It's just something that I was watching videos on, like, the New Horizon Islands and, like, you know, just like exploring different islands. And one of them, they were talking about Tom Nook and how he actually used to be a failing businessman. And it was actually kind of sad, but I guess it was from a previous game.
Like he failed in another game and...
Yeah.
And got banished to the island and...
I don't know if that's like how it came to be on the island, but I know that's like part of his past. Because they actually showed a clip of it. I think it was in like City Folk?
Okay.
Maybe, or Wildlife?
Wild World.
Wild World.
Yeah.
That might have been the one. I don't know. It was an older game, though, because the graphics weren't as good.
Where do you come from on the island? Like, how do you get to go to the island?
Right. I don't even remember.
It doesn't really explain that. Like, in the other games, you know, you're in the car with, you know, Captain,
mm-hmm.
you know, or wherever. Maybe you're on the car, you know, on one of them you're on, like, a train, you know. But you're, I mean, I guess this one you're on a plane. But I feel like they at least explain a little bit more.
Well, it's even a little bit different because you kind of had like that personality type test.
Yeah,
to kind of like design
yeah,
your character.
You did. Yeah, that would be. Yeah, you have like those questions you'd answer, and that would like determine like how you looked or something.
Yeah.
So yeah, there was like a personality test before that, and they didn't really have that this time. They just kind of were like, I mean, you're just kind of at the airport, and it's like, well, let's go to this island, and there really wasn't. Like, why are you going to the island? And the other games, you're moving. Like, you're moving out of home, I think. Well,
yeah.
Maybe some of them. But, like, you're moving. And they make that apparent that, like, you're moving. This one, you just decide to go to this random desert island that has nothing. I mean, what what calls you to go there?
Who knows?
It's weird.
And then why is the, like, villager not freaked out by it being a bunch of animals that it can talk to?
Well, right. Isn't the villager lonely? Like, I guess you play with your other friends and stuff, but, like, you guys can't, like, move in together. So, like, you can't... Like, in the Animal Crossing world, you can never, like, have a relationship with somebody because you both live on two different islands and... I guess you're not allowed. I mean, I guess in your real life, if you're all playing on the same Switch,
yeah.
you live on the same island. That's
and I've
so
actually
weird.
Seen people do some pretty cool stuff with that.
Really?
Like, this girl, she's in one of the groups that I'm in on Facebook. She posted how her boyfriend got tired of playing the game or whatever. So she just turned his house into, like, a little library.
Oh.
I'm like, oh, that's cute.
So you can go in and decorate the other person's house, or did she have to log in as his to decorate it?
I don't know. I think you can go into the other person's house.
Okay, okay.
And decorate. You might just be able to go in. I know you can go in, but I don't know if you can decorate or take things away. Because it's like if... Like, say I had two people on my Switch on my island.
Yeah.
They could move stuff around on the
island.
On
the island, but not in your house.
So, it's like, well, they might be able to. I don't know.
Right. I wouldn't want somebody to live on my island.
Yeah.
I don't like that. I'm already... Oh, you guys, my island. Let me tell you about my island. That's a weird topic.
Yeah, there you go.
So, I decided to... I named my island Pavilia. If you don't know what Pavilia is, let me learn you a little something. Pavilia was this island in Italy, or off the coast of Italy, where they used to take people that were dying from the Black Plague, and they'd take them off to this island for quote-unquote treatment, where, you know, the people would basically just go to die. It was just an island that you went to die because you were dying from the plague. So I thought that... you know, it would be an extremely poor taste during this pandemic for me to make my island, you know, depressing and pandemic-based. So, I just got a new flag. It's a sad face. You haven't been to my island yet. I just got done making my cemetery. So, my cemetery is pretty much almost done.
Right, you should have came to my town and got that golden casket.
I know. Well, that's what happens.
That's weird. That's what fucking Colton was making today. Like, why is there a freaking casket?
That is weird. Like,
in a kid's game.
Why do they have caskets? You know, that's...
Gravestones.
Right. All kinds of... I mean, I'm thankful that they do. But it's, you know...
I think pretty much everybody has a graveyard on their island, or at least anticipates putting one in.
Well, I think that's just the people we know. I don't know. I haven't been to another island with a graveyard. I've seen other people have graveyards, but I haven't been to one when there's one. So, I don't know. Mine's really big. It's got like these stone steps that lead up to it. It's great. I have like a little sitting area. I have like a table with like tissues on it. It's awesome. I like it. It's great.
So they can cry.
Awesome. Right. So you can sit there and cry. Yeah. Mourn. I'm excited. So now that my graveyard is pretty much complete, I'm going to start working on like a medical ward for people. So, bitch, if you see any medical supplies, let me know, because...
Do they have them?
Yeah, there's all kinds of stuff.
Well, I know they have the nurse's outfit.
They do. I'm sure... I'm sure that you can probably get a hospital bed. Like, I'm almost sure of it. If probably. Not, I could probably... Well, honestly, I could probably take the bunk... Have you seen the bunk beds?
Mm-hmm.
They're just kind of like steel and plain. I could probably take those and make those hospital beds.
Yeah.
And then, like, different things. Like, I saw a stack of, like, documents... Mm-hmm. And I got that, and then there's like a magazine, like an open face magazine. I got that. There's like a thing that you sit and like scales and stuff. I mean, there's all kinds of stuff you can get. So I mean, I can make it happen. I can make a little medical ward happen.
Just a little creative work.
Yeah. So you know, I'm gonna do that. But yeah, so eventually, guys, you can come visit my island, and I mean, you can come visit it now, it's just not done, but it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm excited. Yours is kind of a weird one, too.
Yeah, stay alone.
Yeah? Yeah?
I haven't really decided, like, how I'm going to, like, really decorate the town. Like, yeah. I definitely wanted to have, like, witchy vibes, obviously, right. But... there's not really, like, a whole lot to kind of work off of. I mean, they have, like, the divination set, which I have. And I have two colors so far. I don't know if that's all there is or if that's just all I've seen.
Yeah.
But it's, like, what am I going to do? Throw those all over the town, you know? Yeah. But I'm kind of hoping that Halloween has some good stuff.
Oh, okay, I see.
And then just use all of that. But I also got the iron and stone fencing, and like Aaron, my roommate, she was like, "You could make a graveyard with that." I was like, "Or I could just use it all throughout my town."
Yeah.
So I don't know. I am trying to go with like more like old timey type themed stuff.
Yeah.
So like my bridges are gonna be stone.
Okay.
My pathways are gonna be stone. I might do some brick too.
Yeah, I need to do better at that. I just put all the fencing around on my orchards, and I just went with like plain wood fencing. I should probably make it stone or something, so that way it kind of fits the theme more.
Well, I haven't checked, but I wonder if you could do, like, customization on, like, the wood.
I don't think so. I don't think so. No, I don't know that one anyway. Yeah.
I did see on your pathways, like, if you stack your designs, so, like, if you use the actual construction tool and you lay your path and then you get a custom design and you put it on top.
Yeah.
You'll still get that clicking, so...
Oh, really?
Yeah. But if you, like, say you lay a brick path, but you want the bricks to be pink.
Okay.
You would make a design where everything is colored in pink, except for a square. You would make that transparent, and it'll actually pick up the underneath
That's cool.
texture.
That's cool. So if you wanted, like, kind of like a mossy look, you would make, like, the brick. You know, say you do the brick or whatever. And then if you want, like, mossiness on top of that, you'd get, like, an ivy pattern. Oh, an ivy pattern.
Yeah.
Yeah, you'd get, like, an ivy pattern. And like,
I have so much stuff saved for that.
You would lay down your ivy, do you? A lot of designs and stuff saved. Yeah.
I've been trying to find one that's, like, crystals.
Yeah.
But the ones that I have found, the background is transparent. So they would stick out on top of, like, the brick.
I see.
I don't know how, well, the stone, which I don't know how that would look, but I'm willing to play around.
Yeah, you can always download it and make sure, and just, I mean, you can change it. That's the beautiful thing about Animal Crossing, guys, is that you can just change it. That's So, I don't know, I'm trying to think of other weird Animal Crossing things.
What I wonder is why they gave us so much creative freedom in this one. Like, they didn't really phase it in.
They did, though. They had Happy Home Designer, kind, which was like a more of a designing tool.
But nobody played that.
That's true. That's true. I didn't, so I don't even know.
I mean, there are people who played it, obviously, but
I really didn't. I don't know why either. I think that they do give you more stuff as time goes on. Like the last game, you were able to build stuff outside, and you can kind of pick where it was. But it was like how you build like the bridges and inclines now. Like, you'd have to get donations, and then it would be there, you know. So, I mean, you had some customization. I just think the interface is better. Obviously, they had to do more with the game, or nobody would want to play it, you know. So, but, oh my gosh, what a time for it to come out. I mean, they really banked on it. I don't know. I don't know if it sold because it was just anticipated to sell like that anyway, or if it, you know, really sold.
Because it's been, what, 8 years?
Seven or 8 years. Almost 10 years, yeah. Yeah, since the last one. Right, because I was excited.
People have been waiting.
I've been waiting for this. Like, I went and I bought my Switch just because of Animal Crossing. Right. And because of Pokemon or,
I think a lot of people did, because they've been selling out. So it's either, like, they're getting it because of Animal Crossing, or they're getting it because we're in quarantine.
Right.
But I've also heard a lot of people are downgrading to the Switch Lite.
That's what I got. I ended up getting the Switch Lite, and I like it. Now, it does have its disadvantages. You can't plug it into the TV, you know, which it can be. But I'm not really, I'm more of a solo gamer anyway. I mean, I guess it would be pretty cool to play Animal Crossing on my TV. You know, you could really see everything. I don't know. I just, like, if I'm going to game on something, like, my first choice has always been, like, my handheld systems. Like, that's, you know, that's, I like that. I like a handheld system better. I feel like I can do more. I like that I can take it anywhere with me. I don't know. So, I mean, me personally, I like the Switch Lite a lot. But the thing with the Switch is that if you can make it into, you know, you can make it into a handheld system. So you might as well get the one that has both. I'll tell you, I just bought it because I was stupid and I didn't pre-order the Animal Crossing Switch, which I should have done. Whatever.
Even though I already had one.
Right, should have pre-ordered it and gotten it. I waited, and once this pandemic hit was when I went and got it, because that's when Animal Crossing came out, and I couldn't get anything but the Switch Lite. And I you know, initially regretted it. I'm like, because I was just impatient. I didn't want to wait to play the game, so I just bought the Switch Lite. And like I said, at first I regretted it. I was like, man, this was stupid. Why didn't I just, you know, why don't I just get the other one? But it's okay. I mean, it saved me $100, which is bullshit, because I specifically remember when the Switch came out was originally $299. Or, wait, $199. Right now it's $299. Right. Right. So it was $199.
Was it?
Yeah. It was. Yes, it was.
That's some bullshit.
It was. It has gone up in price because it's been so popular. I think it's been so popular. I know, because I'm looking at, well, I collect games, you know. Maybe everybody else doesn't know. I'm a retro game collector. You know, so I follow these things. And Nintendo is the only system that I stay current on and always have. I'm one of the rare folks that actually owns a Wii U. You do, too.
Yeah.
Yep.
And the original Wii that plays GameCube games.
Oh, look at you. See, I did get rid of my Wii. Well, because I had a GameCube, so it's like I could just play my GameCube games on my GameCube, you know? Sometimes I'll do that.
But now you can't play the Wii games.
Yeah, I can on the Wii U.
On the Wii U.
Right,
yeah,
exactly. Exactly. So I got rid of that Wii. But anyways, so it was cheaper. But now the Switch Lite was $199, and I bought it. And, you know. But I like it. I like it. It's cute. I got the blue one. It's cute.
Yeah. I like my Splatoon Switch.
I like yours too, yeah.
The pink and green. That's what sold me, for real.
Was the colors, yeah. Well, see, I can't do that. That's the disadvantage. I can buy other controllers for it. And so I can still play multiplayer games and stuff. I just have to, like, I can't hook it up to the TV, so I have to set it up somewhere. It's a small screen, but I still can. But the screen still, I mean, it's not, it's maybe an inch smaller than the regular Switch screen. I mean, it's still.
Well, and I'm sure there's going to be some kind of way to put it onto the screen. Like, I'm sure there's going to be a Switch Lite dock that comes out at some point.
You know what? There probably will be. I don't, I mean, I'm sure that there's a workaround somewhere to be able to do that.
Yeah.
You know, it's just, you know, people are smart. So they, you know, they do cool stuff like that all the time. So I, you know, I'm not too worried about it. If it bothers me that much, eventually I'll just go out and get a regular Switch and, you know, when they're not sold out. And, you know, for now I can play the games that I want to play. Cause like I said, it's not like I'm doing a bunch of party gaming anyway right now, except remotely. So, you know, whatever. But, anyway, so what were we talking about? Animal Crossing. I'm trying to think of more. I mean, there's a bunch of creepy pastas. In the last game, you could go to people's islands through the dream machine.
I think
maybe it wasn't you go to different people's islands, but you go to different islands through the dream machine, and it would take you to like a random island. And
I don't think the person actually had to play to get you on to the island.
They just set up that island.
Yeah, I think like once you visited
a town,
once,
I guess. It wasn't an island, it was a town. Yeah.
Once you visited the town, then you could go to the dream machine and it would take you to that town even if that person wasn't playing.
Right. I think. I don't remember exactly how that works, but you went to different places. You went to different towns in that one. And there was people that would set up creepy towns and stuff like that. Oh, that horror town.
Horror Island.
That is really good. Those people. I don't know. You guys are so fucking smart. Like, I swear to God. I'm over here proud of my little itty-bitty cemetery. You guys have this whole ass fucking... all these whole ass horror towns and themes and shit, and I've been playing the game for like a month and I'm not even where you guys are. So
well, apparently there's people that will literally like construct an island just to like make it and then completely deconstruct it and make a new one with a new theme.
Right.
And I'm like, how do you like
when do you sleep?
Right. I've struggled with making my paths.
Right.
And placing my plots. Like, how do you get beyond that? Like, do you just get them down and then you're done?
I would really like to know. If you guys want to talk to me about this, or if you want to talk to Ivy about this, please let us know how you how you conduct yourself in Animal Crossing. I'm just not that creative, I guess. I don't know. I'm trying. So I watch a lot of videos and look at a lot of pictures of like other people's stuff. And, you know, to try to get an idea. So, like, I will steal your ideas. Like,
right.
I am that bitch. I will steal your ideas. Sorry. But, yeah, I mean, I don't know how people get so creative. But, yeah, the Horror Island, that was really cool. You guys should definitely check that out. Because it's spooky. It's cool. What else? I don't know. What I was saying was, at the other one, you know, that people would make those scary islands or whatever, and I mean, but that's not like the game itself. The game isn't like creating that kind of creepiness. And what you had, you know, you had like creepypastas. People write tons of creepypastas about Animal Crossing, which creepypastas are just, you know, bullshit stories. So I don't know. I don't really get into those much because they're not real. So,
yeah,
you know, I like things that I could see as, you know, real or possibly real even. But yeah, I mean, that's one thing. So, I mean, there's some things though. There are some things, you know, about the game, the gyroids, you know, and which we haven't seen yet in the new game.
Well, they're there for like accepting donations.
They are. That's true. That's true.
But there's not like the little figurines.
Right. You used to find them and they made music. You'd put them in your house and they made music. But apparently these, you know, they're associated with death in the Japanese culture. You know, so I mean, that's weird, I guess. But, you know, it's just...
Well, what was creepy was if you didn't save and you came back on, your face would be one of those things.
Yeah, and that's creepy. Scary as fuck. Right. It's like, why did you do this? They're punishing you. That's what they do that. I don't know. You know, that's my daughter's 8, and she plays Animal Crossing, but she plays the, she's been playing the older games, and,
right, because you don't want nobody else on your island.
I sure don't.
Especially her, girl.
Right.
She wouldn't
like it. I know. Oh, my daughter, she's something else, guys. But no, she, whenever she would play the game, you know, she's not very good at video games, I'll say that, which is weird because you'd think she would be, but she doesn't really get it most of the time. But she wouldn't save the game in Animal Crossing, and she'd go to turn around later, and she would cry when that fucking guy came on and started yelling at you for not saving. She hated it so much. She would throw the DS at me and cover her ears. She hated it. She was scared of him.
Oh, God.
I don't know why. She just didn't want to be yelled at, I guess. I mean, I feel her pain. I'm like, girl, he's annoying, but he's not scary. He's a dog to you for like 2 hours about saying
right. Like, she never actually skipped the dialogue.
She got to a point to where she couldn't. I mean, she wouldn't even play the game because by the time she was done, by the time he was done, it was, you know, time to stop playing it. I don't know. It was just that. I think that's funny. So my daughter apparently is scared of Animal Crossing. But yeah, so there are a lot of weird things about it. But like, just, I mean, that's any game. A lot of video games have Easter eggs and conspiracies. I mean, you know, like Pokemon's got Lavender Town. That's a big one. Mm-hmm. You know, so I mean, I think that's pretty common for games to have those things. I mean, and I think that a lot of the times the game developers, you know, put that shit in there on purpose because
right.
they want to garner, you know, more attention and, you know, market it better. And so when you have adults, you know, digging through games and finding stuff like that, then it gets adults interested in video games again, especially stuff like Animal Crossing, you know, because it's obviously a game geared more towards children. So, like, the children, it goes over their head, I guess, unless they're playing it at 3:33 in the morning on a Saturday night. Can right. you imagine? I mean, really, can you imagine being a child and that happens?
Yeah, I know I personally would freak
I'd
the
cry.
Fuck out. Because, like...
It's late, you know. You're...
When did it come out on the GameCube?
Oh, I have no idea.
I'm wondering how old I would be.
I think I was, like, 9 or 10... Between the ages of like 9 or 10 when the GameCube came out. So probably around then. So I wasn't that young. You're probably you're like a year older than me, so you know, a little bit older.
Excuse me?
You're a year older than
me. Did
you
just call me older?
I did. I said you're older.
For your information, it's matured.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're a little more mature than I am.
Thank you.
My bad. But no, so yeah, I mean, you probably around that age, but that's still an age where I would have been scared.
Yeah,
as an adult I would have been scared of seeing that right now. Look at aliens, I'm scared of them.
Like, you know what, I'm gonna just go on ahead and turn this game off.
I think that like real life aliens had like interfered with my game. If I didn't know that was a thing and I just discovered it on my own, that's what I would assume. I'm so scared.
They're making contact.
Yes. They have that kind of technology. I mean, they probably do if they can fly through space. You know, fuck that. I don't know. I just want to know. Like, I want to know who the first person was that discovered that. And I want to know what the fuck they thought when it happened.
Yeah.
I'm so curious.
Well, I do like how this new one has, like, space-themed
yeah.
items.
Yeah.
Celeste actually gave my roommate Erin a UFO.
She did?
Mm-hmm. I got the moon. It's a full moon.
Aww.
And it looks so cute. I seen her on somebody else's
I've
island.
Seen the
I haven't
moon
made
too.
It yet.
I want it. Yeah. I haven't had Celeste in a minute. I guess she only comes like once a week or something. I think they all
yeah.
come once a week. And I think you just don't know who you're going to get.
Which it seems like, right, is it only one of those people for the entire week? Or do they all come once a week?
Somebody typically comes to your island once a day. And like, so you won't get other people. Like today I have Red. So, because I have Red, I can't have CJ. Because Red's there. Is what I'm hearing.
Well, see, I had Red and Leaf on the same day.
That
so
did happen
Red
for
might be
a
the
lot
exception,
of people. I think the people selling stuff that set up there, like, well, maybe not, though. Like, label.
Well, Red
and,
has, like, his own little area.
Yeah.
So, maybe he is, like,
this is
not
like
affected by
Animal
that.
Crossing Basics 101, like you should know, but I haven't looked it up because honestly I kind of like waking up and being surprised by
yeah.
who's on my island.
except for when I fucking saw all my fish, and then I go into my house and see fucking CJ in the background, like, where the fuck were you
just
2 minutes ago?
I've been saving, like, the higher dollars, like, fish and bugs. Like, anything that sells, like, anything that's more worth more than, like, 3,000 bells, I will keep. But I know you're running out of space. And you were you got the terraforming tools, so you're good now. Getting your island rating up. Yeah. They don't like it when you have shit hanging around. So, like, that's probably why it took you a minute to get it compared to, like, everything else, because you had all that stuff outside.
No, I didn't. I mean, I had all that stuff out, but it's because I dropped the item. I didn't place the item. If you place the item, gets your rating up, because it doesn't matter what you have out there.
Yeah, the game's dumb and it doesn't.
Yeah. And I didn't realize that.
It doesn't care about your decorating, really.
Right. As long as the shit's there.
Right. That's it. That's all that matters. Yeah. Like the Happy Home Academy. Well, who the fuck are they? You know?
Exactly.
Who, like, are they?
Reveal yourself. Right. Like, remember in New Leaf, you could go, like, into, like, the shopping
Nook
center.
Was. Yeah.
And then, like, keep going. Yeah. And there would be all the, like, houses that you'd visited or something.
Yeah. Well, there was the town or whatever.
Yeah.
It was like you had your little town, and then you had, like, the shopping area was separate.
Yeah.
I like that.
I did too.
I'm kind of sad. I mean, I guess it's cool. You can make your own shopping area. I get that, but it's a pain in the ass.
Yeah.
Especially because you don't get that. Like, you really don't know what the fuck you're doing when you first open a game. So, like, you don't know where the hell you want to place your stuff, like, immediately. But
well, see,
and Nook knows
I think
that.
I'm gonna start putting my, like, Nook and Able Sisters, like, in the back of my island, so that way people are forced.
They have to walk through
to
it.
Explore.
Yeah, that's true.
But
I
then people will probably also avoid my island.
They won't
because it's
come.
Like,
right,
because
I know I like that when people have their shit right there.
Yeah.
So, like, they put all their houses right there, and they put their Nooks and their Ables right there. Yeah, I like that. I'm probably gonna keep it that way. That's how I've been, like, kind of doing it. I've only moved one house, and I haven't really decided what I'm gonna do yet with that one house. I thought about kind of making everybody their own, like, little cliff.
Yeah, I've seen the cliff houses, and they're super cute.
They are. I know. I thought about doing that. You know,
but
and then
it's like, I want my
that's a
house
lot of money.
On the cliff.
Well, you can make your own cliff.
Yeah, I know.
I think I know exactly where I'm going to put my house. It's going to have its own cliff.
Yeah, mine's going to be, there's going to be a cliff behind it, but it's going to be in front of my museum, in front of the waterfalls.
Okay.
Like, right in the middle.
Let's see, and then if you put your Nooks and stuff back there. Like, that's the only thing I think, is that you at least want to keep your house near your shops.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do with mine yet. I need to put somebody in isolation. Like, somebody needs to be in quarantine, somebody's house. And we've talked about maybe it should be my house. Because mine's, like, the best house. I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm not
and then
sure.
Everybody else is the one with the disease.
Right.
Trying to keep clean.
I mean, I've been there the longest, so... I mean, you would think that I would have recovered by now, but I don't know. It's going to be really cool, guys. My community board and everything is, like, has, like, a story in it. It's fun. It's a lot of fun. I've been making it fun. But I've been spacing out because you can only have, like, 6 at a time, right? Is that right?
What?
On your community board, your bulletin board thing?
I don't know.
I think you can only have the 6 at a time. You have to delete one. And then, of course, like, some events and things will be posted there, so... I don't know.
Yeah, they post their birthdays.
The
if you look up your characters online, it'll tell you their star
everything
signs.
Everything about them. Does it?
Yes. It's so cute.
Animal Crossing is really... They should have called this one not New Horizons. They should have called it New Age.
Yes. I'm here for it.
It's really hip now.
Because they
really
have like a miniature Stonehenge you can get.
Yeah, they do. Yeah. Well, yeah. And then you got caskets and shit. I mean... Well, and then, like... You know, all the clothes are, like, gender neutral and stuff. I mean, they're not, but, like, it's not, you can change your appearance however you want to.
Right. You can be male,
so,
you can be female,
at any time,
but
right.
You can be, like, anything in between,
right.
Too.
You can always change it. And so, you can change it the same day if you want to. So, I mean, that's cool. You know, so it's definitely a lot more, I mean, it's just a lot more advanced, I guess, with that kind of stuff, you know.
See, where
and there's
I
no
struggle.
Romantic relationship, so that's never
yeah.
been a thing. You wish there were?
No, it's just like, it's weird. Like, you're kind of like on this island by yourself, but like you don't miss home, you don't like
right. You don't want to interact with another person
or anything. Yeah. And then it's like when you see these people, like you don't feel anything other than like what you make them feel. Like,
what do you mean?
Like, cause the like little emoticon things you can do.
Oh, I see. Well, that's true, cause you gotta force it.
Yeah. And so I mean, I guess you could kind of make it like a little relationship type thing.
Yeah. If you wanted to. I've seen a lot of people do a lot of fun. Like, it's really become like a big thing with like people like role playing. And I think that's cool. Like, I've seen like people are hosting graduations on Animal Crossing. They're doing weddings. Like, they're doing like events, and it's cool because people get into it. You know?
Yeah, they actually had a YouTube video that was like a bunch of different like wedding venues. Like, people are going all out with this shit. It's
people are
crazy.
Going on dates. I know. It's
people
it's
are
cute.
Making diners,
yeah.
And like everything. Like,
yeah.
It's so cute.
I think it's really fun how people are able to connect with it. You know, so it's really. At least given everybody that sense of, you know, I bet if you took a poll and you asked people, and you ask people who have played Animal Crossing if they are lonely right now in the quarantine, I bet a lot of them would say no. And then more people that don't have Animal Crossing would probably say yes, because really you still have that sense of community, you know, with something like Animal Crossing.
Yeah.
You know, that's one thing that I noticed. Everybody in the Animal Crossing communities, they're pretty fucking nice. Like, everybody's usually pretty cool.
Like, yeah, like, if there's anything you need, let me know.
Right, but for
the
most
part.
You
got all your fruits.
Yeah, they will take care of you. Like, they don't mind.
Or you say something like, ooh, I like this lamp post.
Right.
And they're like, oh, I might have extras.
Let me get it for you. Right, it's so nice. And so, you know, but I think it's been a lot of fun. You know, obviously, I'm going to keep playing it. And then, you know, as soon as my town's ready, guys, I'll definitely let you know. And then you'll be able to see it. I don't know. Maybe we should host like a public Animal Crossing event.
Fuck it.
Can you chat with people? Isn't there a way for you to like actually voice chat with people?
Mm-hmm. On the phone app.
I think we should set this up. What do you guys think? Do you guys want to do like a public Animal Crossing play with us? We can have a little weird chat and just kind of sit and talk. We'll, you know, I'll set up a space. I'll set up a little area for us to hang out. We can hang out at the cemetery.
Yes.
Or you can all come get your
I'll bring
your
the tarot cards.
Yes.
I literally have a screenshot, and it's like I'm sitting, like I have a tarot mm-hmm. room in my house, and Aaron is sitting on the one side and I'm sitting on the one side, and like I was just like joking with her, and like when she sat down, I said something like, your future looks promising, or like
we could
like
do
that
though, especially if we're doing like a voice chat. You could like be the tarot reader and sit there, and they can come and sit down and get a reading from you,
yeah.
And you could do an authentic reading.
Yeah, I've thought
I think
about
that
doing
would be
it
fun.
Too.
I think that would be really fun. I you know what? I think we're going to do this. I'm going to start advertising this.
I mean, it would be
we'll
a fun way to do, like, long-distance tarot readings.
It would be fun.
You know?
Yeah, it would be fun. I think it would be fun. I think it would be a good way for us to engage with our listeners, and I think they would like it. So, I don't know. I think it's something we should definitely do. We'll do it. We'll figure out the details of it. We'll let you guys know. You know, you can obviously check my social media, my Twitter, my Instagram, both. It's Asherz. And then... Ivy is on also both Twitter and Instagram, but she mainly uses Instagram. What's your profile?
Oh, well, I have two.
Yeah.
I have @SeekAndSeeTarot, and mm-hmm. then I have @she's_a_witch with a Y. But the She's a Witch is my most prominent.
Is it?
Personal account.
Oh, okay.
I've been trying to use my Seek and See Tarot for just my tarot practice,
yeah.
But I've also been in a weird headspace lately and haven't been doing that much.
Yeah. Well, that's okay.
Yeah.
It happens. Well, maybe you should take this, you know, at least the next week to get ready, because we're going to have some Animal Crossing tarot readings coming up. So.
Fuck it, let's do it.
I'm excited about this. I think this is going to be really fun. I'm absolutely looking forward to it. I got to set up a space, and we'll do it. So that's my next project now.
We'll have to post our friend codes.
That's fine. I usually post mine. A lot of my followers can't, they haven't have access to mine. So,
I don't think I have mine posted.
Okay.
So I have to post mine.
I post mine every, like, week, like once a week or so, because I don't know, I like playing with other people, so I don't mind.
You
know?
I mean, I do too, but I don't want, like, a bunch of people that I don't, like,
you don't know.
Not necessarily that I don't know, that I'm not gonna, like, play with.
That's or true.
Be connected with.
That's true.
Because, like, yeah, we might be friends on Facebook, but it's not like we have conversations or, like, interact with each other's posts a lot. Or
well, I feel like that's a really easy way to, like, get into contact with somebody. Like, to really connect with another person is to be like, hey, here's my friend code. Some people that you don't normally talk to would be like, oh, I added you.
Yeah.
And then,
well, I mean, when I play the game and, like, I run into, like, people, like, how it shows when, like, somebody's on their way, it'll show the character. And if I think their character's cute or, like, I like the way they interact in the game.
Yeah.
Like, if somebody hits me with their net, automatic friend request.
You like that.
Yeah, I think it's funny.
That's kinky.
Unless I'm sitting there talking to Kicks and somebody comes up and they're like, now I'm going to just take my sweet precious time.
Does it fuck with you if they do that?
No.
Okay.
That's just them telling you to hurry the fuck up.
Oh, is
and,
it?
Yeah, an basically. That's the way I take it. So if you see me talking to a salesperson, don't hit me with your net because it's going to be a while.
But any other time, it's fair game. Yeah. Do you, like, flinch or anything when you get hit with a net? Mm-mm. You don't? You just stand there and take it.
Well, you're talking to the salesperson. You can't.
I know, but, like, when you're not talking to the salesperson.
Oh, no. Flinch? I'll get out my net.
You'll
sometimes I break out the axe.
Oh, yeah.
But I have to be that person's best friend in order to pull out my axe.
Oh, okay.
So if I'm
okay.
just visiting someone and we're not best friends.
And wait, in the game, for real?
Yeah.
You can't pull your axe out unless you're best friends with somebody.
Yeah.
That's fucked up. I guess you can't chop down the trees, but they don't trust you with sharp objects on other people's islands.
I mean, you can still shake the tree and steal their fruit, so.
Well, if they're not your best friend, fuck them. They deserve it.
Right.
A lot of people don't pick their fruits. They just leave them on the trees, and I don't understand that.
That's just them flexing. Like, I got money. I don't need to sell my fruits.
Okay, good for you. I'm trying to grow my town.
I went to this one island, and it was nothing but money trees.
Because once you pay off your house, what do you need to do? Nothing but money trees. Did you take the money?
Mm-mm.
I would have.
That's rude.
That is rude.
Y'all worked hard on that.
But that's a lot of money.
It was a lot of fucking trees,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, that's a lot of money at the same time. I don't know you. What are you going to do?
Ban me from your island? Well, guess what? I got $300,000 off your
VPN. Right. Bye.
It's like, thank you for having me. And then you go look through your island and it's like all your money trees are
everything's
shaken.
Everything's
like,
gone. Yeah.
Looking like that Pikachu meme.
Yep. All right, guys. Well, I think we're getting off topic a little, but that's okay. But yeah, we'll definitely set up. I think we should set up this play party. And we'll let you guys know when we're going to do that. But until then, I think we're going to go ahead and wrap up here. And we will talk to you guys next Wednesday. Bye.
Bye.